After we have started Logosoft Comfort, we are ready to create our first project. To create a new project, we have to click on the icon in the left upper corner of the screen. Then we need to specify the properties of the project, such as the project name or the author. Let's call our project Introductory Project. Logosoft Comfort is a Windows application, so working with it should be relatively easy for you. Here we have the standard toolbar, then all the main functions needed for programming and, to the left, the programming toolbox. The join tool allows you to create connections between the blocks. Constants and terminals icon displays connections available in the program. GF button shows you the basic functions and SF button the special functions. Now we will create our first program, which will either actuate or deactuate the outputs based on the input conditions. To insert any kind of input into our program, we have to click on the input icon on the left and drag it onto the programming area. Now, by clicking the left mouse button, we add inputs into our programming area. If we want to remove any of the elements we have added, we can do it in two ways. The first one, we right-click on a given element and choose Delete from the list. And the second one, we select several elements and delete them together. We will now insert four inputs into our program. Notice that I'm placing them at random positions. In a second, I will show you an easy way to move the inputs to their desired positions. Let's select our inputs. Now, we will align them using the vertical align tool. We can also move our blocks by using arrows on our keyboard. Let's now add four outputs which will be controlled by our inputs. We press F5 on the keyboard and switch to the join tool. To draw our connections, we need to select the end of one element and, holding down the mouse key, draw the line to the second element. We connect the remaining blocks. And in this way, we have just written the first program, which allows us to control the outputs Q1 to Q4 through inputs I1 to I4. Let's save our program. Then we will see how it works by switching to the simulation mode. We start our simulation process by clicking on the simulation icon in the corner of the toolbox or by pressing F3 on the keyboard. When we are in the simulation mode, a toolbox appears in the lower part of the screen. It contains the icons representing our inputs and bulbs allowing us to monitor the outputs. By clicking on I1, we activate the first input. Activated blocks are outlined in red. By closing input I1, we actuated output Q1. This action is signaled by the corresponding bulb. We can also activate given blocks by clicking on them directly in the programming area.